Good morning, Anthony. Good morning, morning, Jose.
Good morning, teacher.
Morning, Sergio.
Morning, teacher.
Morning, Anthony.
Good morning.
How are you guys?
Fine.
You study the simple past? Do you study yesterday simple past?
Little.
A little bit. Okay. Yeah, because today we are going to use it, and we will also check the difference between simple past using all the verbs and simple past of the verb be, because you know that they are different. Yes, so that's what we are going to do today. But before starting, let's see, Anthony, what do you do yesterday at work? What do you do yesterday at work?
Yesterday in my work, I had meeting
I have.
after class, and after the lunch, I was and walk around in the airplane. After this activity, I has meeting again.
I had.
Sorry, have. And
Anthony?
in my home, and in the night, no, in the night we went the church with my family. This is the only relevant activity.
Good, good. Thank you, Anthony. Now let's see. Sergio, what did you do yesterday?
Yesterday in my class after class, I did the cleaning in my house. I did no work. It's my day off. For the afternoon, I did take a shower, and the night, I cooked pupusas with my wife. At the dinner, only.
Okay, good. So all those activities that they are describing, they are in the past, so they have to use the past, yes? So in the case of you're saying I has a meeting, it is in the past. I have a meeting, the past. I was walk has to be I walked. I walked around the airplanes. Yes, I walked. And the other one that you were saying was, let me check over here. When you say, I went to work, so you only say, I went to work. You don't say, I went to work. It's only, I went to work. Yes? So yesterday we were talking a little bit about simple past, and we were saying that we can have positive sentences, negative sentences, and questions in the past. We were saying that always, for all the ideas that you want to express, you always have a subject, a verb, and a complement or an object. Yes? So subject, verb, and complement. Subjects are people or things. So I, he, she, it, we, you, they, or names. For example, Salvador, Hugo, Herbert. So those are names. So you can mention them too. Then in the verb, you have actions. Yes, actions. For example, eat, work, study, play, cook, sleep, get up. Take a shower. So all those activities. And the complement, giving information about a place, about a date, how you did it, and yes. But something important here is that you have to use the verb in the past. Yes, you cannot use it in the present. Why not? Because you're expressing your idea in the past. So you need to use the verb in the past. For example, you don't have to say, I eat dinner yesterday. This is not possible. You have to use that verb in the past. How do you say it? Let's see, Herbert, how do you say that? I eat dinner yesterday.
I eat dinner yesterday.
No, because it is the present, so it
Okay. I
eight.
ate I ate dinner yesterday.
Exactly. I ate dinner yesterday. So you write the verb in the past, not in the present. So I ate dinner yesterday. If you say it negative, in negative, you use an auxiliary. The auxiliary is didn't. So I didn't eat dinner yesterday. And for the negative form, you use the verb in the present. You use the verb in the present. Why? Because you have didn't, and didn't is in the past. So the word didn't is in the past, the auxiliary is in the past. So the verb is gonna be just in the present. I didn't eat dinner yesterday. I didn't go. I didn't drink. Swim. Yes? So you use it in the present. But if it is a question, you will use the auxiliary too. And you will say, did you eat dinner yesterday? Did you eat dinner yesterday? And this is the question. You use did and the verb in the present. Did you go? Did you drink? Did you play? Did you study? Did you swim? Did you get up? Did you take? So whatever you want to ask, you use did, and the verb in the present. So as you can see, the only moment where you have to use the past is in positive sentences. Not in questions, not in negative, only in positive sentences. Yes? So when we ask questions, we use did. With all the verbs that you can imagine, with all the verbs, except with the verb can and the verb be. With the verb be, you don't say did. With can, you don't say did. For example, if you want to say something like, pudiste completar los ejercicios? Pudiste completar los ejercicios? You don't have to say, did you can? Did you can complete the exercises? So this is not possible. Why not? Because did and can don't go together. So how do you do it? You need to use can in the past. So you only say, could you complete the exercises yesterday? Could you complete the exercises yesterday? And this is when you say pudiste. Yes. Could you complete the exercises yesterday? Yes. And the answer, yes, I could, or no, I couldn't. Yes, I could, or no, I couldn't. Yes. So in the answer, you don't say, yes, I did, or no, I didn't. Mm-mm. This is yes, I could, or no, I couldn't. Positive, I could. Negative, I couldn't. So if you want to say, for example, no pude entrar, I couldn't enter. No pude escuchar, I couldn't hear. No pude abrir, I couldn't open. Yes? So you don't say didn't when you have can. You only say couldn't. So I repeat it, there are only two verbs that you're not going to use with did in the question or did in negative. Those two verbs are number one, can, and number two, the verb be. Yes, so this example is with can. You only use could. With the verb be, you don't use did, you only use the verb be. And the verb be in the past is was and were. Was and were. This is the verb in the past. In the present, am, is, are. This is the verb in the present. But in the past, only was and were. Was and were. Yes? So, was will be for I, he, she, and it. Was. Was for I, for he, for she, and for it. So you would say, I was, he was, she was, it was. Yes, and you're saying, yo era o yo estaba. Yes, yo era o yo estaba. Yo era pequeño en escuela. I was short in school. Yo estaba feliz ayer. I was happy yesterday. Yes? So you only use was for I, he, she, and it. For we, for you, and for they, you will use were. We were in class yesterday. Nosotros estuvimos en clase ayer. We were in class yesterday. Yes? Or nosotros éramos felices en el pasado. We were happy in the past. Yes? So you don't use did, you don't use didn't, you don't use anything. You only use the verb be. Now, what happened if I want to make it negative? For example, positive. I was in my house yesterday. Positive. I was in my house yesterday. Negative. I wasn't in my house yesterday. I wasn't in my house yesterday. Wasn't is the contraction of was not. So in other words, you won't say, I didn't. I didn't. Mm-mm. I wasn't. I wasn't in my house yesterday. No estuve en mi casa ayer. I wasn't in my house yesterday. Yes? Now, if it is a question, was he or was Louis in class yesterday? Was Louis in class yesterday? ¿Estaba Louis en clase ayer? Was Louis in class yesterday? So you don't say did. You only use the verb be. Yes, was Louis in class yesterday? And the answer? Yes, he was, in class yesterday. Or no, he wasn't in class yesterday. So as you can see, positive, only the verb be, negative, the verb be, but with not, the contraction wasn't or weren't, and like that. Yes? So this is how you know how to ask in the past. Yes? You can give information about whatever you want, but when it is the verb be and can, you need to pay attention, because you have to remember that can will never have did for question or didn't for negative. And you have to remember that the verb be will never have did in question or didn't in negative, because they work independently. Yes? They are independent. They don't use auxiliaries. Yes? So that's something that you have to remember. Do you have any questions about it? No?
No, teacher.
Okay. Now, in which situations are you going to use the verb be? Well, the verb be is going to be used when you are asking about description or location. Listen again. Description or location. Acuérdense que el verbo to be significa ser o estar. Entonces, description, ser. ¿Ser qué? Ser alto, delgado, inteligente, ser un maestro, ser un doctor, ser un mecánico. ¿Yes? O ser amable. So, description. Location, estar. Estar en una casa, estar en el trabajo, estar en clases, estar en el parque. Yes? So that is the verb be, ser o estar. In the past, era o estaba. In the present, ser o estar. In the past, era o estaba. Yes? So I can tell you, for example, I was in the supermarket yesterday at 7 p.m. So I was in the supermarket yesterday at 7 p.m. I wasn't in my house yesterday at 7 p.m. Yes? So you don't say didn't, you only say wasn't. Then didn't is for all the verbs that you can imagine. But with the verb be and with can, you don't use auxiliaries. Summarizing. Siempre van a ocupar el verbo en el pasado cuando la oración sea positiva. Siempre. Si es negativa, ustedes ocupan didn't. Pero ustedes van a ocupar didn't con todos los miles de verbos que existen, pero no con dos. No lo van a ocupar con can y no lo van a ocupar con el verbo to be. El verbo to be was and were. No se puede. Ellos trabajan independientes y ellos van a hacer su forma negativa solamente poniéndole not. Entonces, si el verbo can en el pasado es could, solo póngale could not y eso es el negativo. O la contracción couldn't. Si el verbo to be en el pasado es was and were, solo póngale not y eso es el pasado. Was not o la contracción wasn't. Were not o la contracción weren't. ¿Yes? Y estamos hablando del pasado del verbo to be. Entonces solamente ocupamos un verbo. Porque no estamos hablando de algo que estaba en proceso. Solamente estamos hablando de algo que estuvo en un lugar o que era de cierta manera, solamente. No estamos describiendo algo que una persona estaba haciendo, porque si queremos describir lo que alguien estaba haciendo, yo puedo, si yo digo, por ejemplo, Rubén was eating dinner yesterday. Rubén was eating dinner yesterday when he received a call. But si yo les digo, Rubén was eating dinner yesterday when he received a call, ahí lo que les estoy haciendo es describiendo que una acción estaba en proceso cuando otra sucedió e interrumpió la acción primera. Entonces, yo decirles que Rubén estaba comiendo cena es que estoy describiendo que una acción estaba en proceso y algo interrumpió, ¿sí? Entonces, ese ya es otro tiempo. Esto no se llama simple past. Esto se llama past continuous, porque ustedes están describiendo algo que una persona estaba haciendo en un momento que sucedió otra cosa, ¿sí? Entonces, ese ya es otro tiempo. Normalmente, el simple past solamente tiene un verbo. Un verbo. Entonces, ustedes dicen, I cooked yesterday. ¿Sí? Un verbo. ¿Vean? Un verbo. I went to the beach yesterday. ¿Sí? Un verbo. I drank coffee last night. ¿Me fijan? Un verbo. Entonces, siempre va un verbo. Entonces, si quieren poner el verbo to be en el pasado, solamente ponen el verbo to be. Entonces, ustedes van a decir, I was in the shower at 6 a.m. I was in the shower at 6 a.m. Today in the morning is past. 6 a.m. is past. 9 a.m. is past because it is almost 10. Yes? So I was in the shower at 6 a.m. So you only use one verb. If you want to use two verbs, like for example, if you want to say yo fui a comprar, so then you say I went to buy. I went to buy to the supermarket. Yes, I went to eat with my friends yesterday. So in that case, one verb is in the past, went. Then the other one is in infinity, went to buy, went to eat, went to study, and like that. If you want to make negative, remember that you use didn't. So you say, I didn't go, I didn't drink, I didn't eat. But if you say, I was in negative, you only say, I wasn't. I wasn't in the shower at 6 a.m. Yes? If it is a question, use did. Did you go? Did you drink? Did you eat? Did you study? But if it is the verb be, don't use did. Use only the verb be. Were you in class yesterday? Were you in the shower at 6 a.m.? Was Roxana in class yesterday? And like that. Yes? So this is how we use the verb be and the simple past. So I'm going to show you on the screen some other examples. And there you have on the left the past of the verb be, and on the right the past of all the verbs. So let's start with Roxana. Roxana will read the past of be, and Luis is going to read the simple past of the rest of verbs.
Teacher, I have a little question.
Yes, Hugo?
So, I don't understand completely. So what is the difference, the past progressing simple past? I know that simple past, you told you that simple past is the action in the past. So in the past progressive is an action in the past. But what is the difference?
The past continuous or past progressive is an action that was in progress when another action happened. So I was,
yeah, when is the, for example, when you say Abismael was I don't remember. Abismael was
eating,
his food when he received the call.
Yes.
So the action in the past interrupt the other action.
Exactly. One action was in progress. One action was in progress. Abimael was eating. What interrupted the action? He received a call and he stopped eating. But that is another tense. Ese es otro tema que van a ver más adelante. Solamente se los di para que no vayan a estar confundiendo y me vayan a cuando yo les pregunte qué hicieron ayer y me van a responder I was working yesterday. Eso sí, no, ¿verdad? Ustedes me dicen I worked yesterday. ¿Sí? O ¿qué hiciste en tu cumpleaños pasado? Y que me vayan a decir I was eating cake, o que me digan I was ate cake. No, ¿verdad? Solamente se dice I ate a cake. ¿Por qué? Porque si ustedes dicen I was eating, me estaban diciendo yo estaba comiendo. Y eso no, ¿verdad? Ustedes dicen eso cuando ustedes van a contar una historia. Si ustedes van a contar una historia y ustedes quieren relatar lo que estaba sucediendo y de repente algo interrumpió, ahí sí, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, un día yo estaba caminando en la calle cuando de repente me encontré $50. Yo estaba caminando en la calle cuando de repente algo pasó e interrumpió mi acción. ¿Qué pasó? Me encontré $50, entonces detuve mi marcha. ¿Sí? Entonces eso es past continuous. Describir algo que estaba en proceso y que de repente algo sucedió. Eso es past continuous. ¿Yes? Simple past nada más describe algo. ¿Qué pasó? Inició y terminó. No está describiendo que estaba en proceso y algo le interrumpió. No, aquí solamente se quiere decir yo estuve en clase ayer. Nada más. Yo era el número uno de la clase en escuela. ¿Terminó? Yes? So that's the only thing that you want to express. So if you have the verb be in the simple past, you only have the verb be. You don't have another verb. Mm-mm. Simple past, it's only one verb in the past. If you have the verb be in the past. If you have another verb, that verb in the past. If it is negative, didn't. But if it is the verb be, mm-mm, you don't use didn't. You only say wasn't or weren't. And like that. Yes?
That's great.
Okay, another question? No? Okay, now Roxana, the past of be, and Luis, simple past.
It was a great experience. The agent was very helpful. You were on our page. We were excited about services.
Luis?
I gave my account information. He called yesterday at night.
Luis?
Night.
Luis?
The program.
He has a problem with his internet.
Can you hear me?
Luis, can you repeat it?
Okay. I gave my account information. He called. Yesterday at night, well, they bought that product last week.
Okay, thank you. So Roxana said, it was a great experience. Fue una gran experiencia. It was a great experience. The agent was very helpful. El agente fue muy útil. You were on our page. Tú estuviste en nuestra página. You were on our page. We were excited about the service. Estuvimos emocionados por el servicio. Now, with all the rest of verbs, I gave my accounts information. I gave my accounts information. Di mi información de la cuenta. He called yesterday night. Él llamó ayer por la noche. The program worked well. El programa funcionó bien. They bought that product last week. Ellos compraron ese producto la semana pasada. So as you can see, you only use the verb in the past, if it is positive. Now, how do you change this to negative? Let's see. Abimael. Read the past of be, but in negative. And Rubén García, the simple past, but in negative. The past of be, Abimael, in negative. And then Rubén, all the verbs in the simple past in negative.
The same sentence or the...
The past of...
The past of be.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It wasn't...
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't a great experience.
Perfect.
The agent wasn't very helpful. You weren't on our page, and we weren't excited about service.
Good, thank you. So this is the correct way. It wasn't. The agent wasn't, you weren't, we weren't. Good. Now, the simple past in negative?
Simple past.
Yes, the simple past of the rest of verbs.
I gave my ACON information.
But in negative, negative.
Ah, in negative, okay. I didn't get.
You cannot use the verb in the past if you have didn't.
What, teacher?
The verb is not in the past if you say didn't. No puede tener el verbo en el pasado.
Ah, yes. No remember the present. I didn't get my ACON information. He didn't call yesterday at night. The program didn't work well. They both. No remember, teacher, the boat.
By the boat is by the boat.
By they didn't buy that product last week.
Good. So you only use didn't and the verb in the present. I didn't give. He didn't call. The program didn't work. They didn't buy. So you need the verb in the present to make it negative. Now, if it is a question, Salvador Gomez, how do you create the questions using the past of be on the left? And Herbert, how do you create the questions using the simple past with the rest of verbs. Acuérdense que aquí estamos diferenciando nada más el verbo to be en el pasado y el resto de los miles de verbos que existen en el pasado, ¿verdad? ¿Cómo es la estructura de ellos? So, Salvador, transform the sentences into questions. Las oraciones que está ahí las tiene que pasar a preguntas. Las del verbo to be. Y Herbert, la del resto de verbos en el pasado, las va a crear en preguntas. So, let's start.
Was it a great experience?
Perfect.
Was the agent very helpful?
Good.
Were you on our page?
Perfect.
Were we excited about service?
Great. So as you can see, the only thing that you have to do is to switch position. Lo único que hacen cuando es una pregunta es cambiar la posición. Primero ponen el verbo to be, después el sujeto. Si es una oración, primero el sujeto y después el verbo to be. Pregunta, cambia la posición. Now, questions with the rest of verbs. Ahora, ¿cómo se hacen las preguntas con los miles de verbos? Porque este era como se hacía nada más con el verbo to be, porque el verbo to be es especial. Acuérdense que no va a ocupar auxiliar, no va a ocupar did en la pregunta, ni va a ocupar did en el negativo. Él es como un superhéroe, entonces no necesita auxiliares. Pero el resto, los miles de verbos, sí necesitan auxiliares. Entonces, por eso, sus compañeros dijeron, I didn't give, he didn't call, the program didn't work. Porque necesitan un auxiliar para hacer un negativo. Now, Herbert, questions?
I did get my account information.
Repeat it.
I did give my account information.
No, you need to create a question. Necesita hacerlo pregunta.
Okay.
Entonces, como este no es el verbo to be, entonces significa que usted necesita un auxiliar para hacerlo pregunta.
I do, teacher.
Vaya, como este no es el verbo to be, usted necesita un auxiliar para hacer la pregunta. Entonces ocupe el auxiliar para hacer la pregunta.
No, teacher.
¿Cuál es el auxiliar para hacer preguntas en el pasado, Herbert?
Do it as.
Vaya, eso es exacto, tiene razón, Herbert. Esos son los auxiliares que se ocupan para hacer preguntas. Do y does son los auxiliares que se ocupan para hacer preguntas, pero ellos se ocupan en el presente.
Ah, ok.
Do y does es para el presente. Ahora, si queremos decir do o does en el pasado, se dice did. Y ese es el auxiliar que se ocupa para el pasado.
Ok, teacher. Sí, o sea, yo le hice la primera pregunta. I did give my
pero una pregunta jamás comienza con el sujeto. Si usted comienza con el sujeto, usted me está diciendo una oración, no una pregunta. Se comienza con el auxiliar.
Did I give my account information?
Ah, that's a question. Did I give my accounts information? Ahí sí es una pregunta. Y lo hizo muy bien porque ya no dijo gave, sino que dijo give. Porque en la pregunta ya tenemos did, entonces el verbo va a ir en el presente. Good, now continue with the rest.
Okay, did he call yesterday at night?
Perfect.
Did the program work well? They buy the product last week.
Perfect.
Okay.
So, did they buy? Because you have did in the question, so you don't need to use the verb in the past. Good. So, as you can see, the verb is in the past only when the sentence is positive. If it is negative, you need to use didn't. And if it is a question, you use did. Good. Now, let's complete the exercises. Tania is going to complete number one. Let's see. Edwin. Edwin Alexander is going to complete number two. Edwin Gonzalez is going to complete number three. Josue is going to complete number four. Hector Lima, number five. Jorge Ramirez, number six. So what you have to do is to write the sentences with the words that you have in parentheses. You have to use the simple past of be or the simple past of the verb that you have over there. Yes? If you need to include another word, you can do it. Si les falta incluir alguna letra o algún artículo, por ejemplo, si le quieren poner the product, entonces póngale the product sin ningún problema. So, number one says, I, this is the verb that you need to use, be, this is the adjective, interesting, and then you have product. So, how do you create the positive sentence?
I was interested product.
I was interested, ahí le faltaría agregar algo. I was interested, estaba interesada, y luego tiene producto. Entonces le faltan dos palabras.
The product.
In the product. I was interested in the product. Estaba interesada en el producto. I was interested in the product. Good. Number two.
Bought the item on December.
You bought the item in December. Exactly. You bought the item in December. Number three.
She read the policy.
Read is the present. Read is the present. You need to use the past.
Okay.
What is the past of read?
The same, read.
No.
It's the same, but you're... the pronunciation is different. It's like a color of red.
Mm-hmm. The letters are the same, but the pronunciation is different in the past. Read is in the present. Read is the past.
Okay. She read the policy.
She read the policies. She read the policies. Good. Number four. Number four. Who was number four? Number four, number four. Who was number four, guys? No one. Okay, let's see.
Maybe the supervisor was giving me a discount. Mm-hmm. No.
No, no, no. You cannot use was in another verb. No puede ocupar was en otro verbo. Solamente se ocupa un verbo. The supervisor gave me a discount. The supervisor gave me. Ahí ya le dieron la respuesta. Ya está el verbo en el pasado. The supervisor gave me a discount. The supervisor gave me a discount. Por error le dieron ya el verbo en el pasado ahí. The supervisor gave me a discount.
Teacher, I have a question.
Number five. Number five.
They sent the contact my email.
They sent the contact to my email. They sent the contact to my email. Enviaron el contacto a mi correo. They sent the contact to my email. Good. Number six.
He was disappointed.
Yeah. He was disappointed or disappointed. He was disappointed. Estaba decepcionado. He was disappointed. Entonces, en ese caso, disappointed no es un verbo, ¿verdad? Sino que es un adjetivo describiendo cómo la persona estaba o cómo la persona se sentía. Yes? Good. So now, let's watch a video. On this video, they will give you more information, but only about the verb be. So I need you to pay attention to it. Ben, any questions?
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
No le escuché muy bien cuando dijo en el simple, no, en el, donde usamos el was y el verbo. Cuando no es to be, sino que vayamos a usar un verbo normal, ¿cómo sería la pregunta, dijo?
Bueno, repito, si es el verbo to be, el verbo to be no necesita, vaya, primero...
Ahí, was, were, ¿verdad?
Exacto, primero que todo, ustedes se tienen que acordar que para pregunta, ustedes necesitan auxiliares. Para negativo también necesitan auxiliares. Para las dos cosas necesitan auxiliar. Para pregunta y para negativo. Entonces, en el pasado, el auxiliar que ocupo para preguntas es be. Y para negativo se ocupa
de.
En positivo, el verbo va en el pasado. ¿Sí? En positivo. En una pregunta tienen did y el verbo en el presente. En la negativa, didn't y en el presente, porque ya did está en el pasado, ¿sí? Eso va a ser con los miles de verbos que existen. Con todos. Did you play? Did you go? Did you eat? Did you drink? Did you visit? Did you give? Did you feed? Did you buy? Negativo, I didn't buy, I didn't read, I didn't study, I didn't eat. Si es positivo, ya saben que el verbo va en el pasado. I ate. I bought, I read, I drank, I went, etc. ¿Sí? Pero esto es con los miles de verbos que existen, pero no con el verbo to be. El verbo to be es independiente. En el pasado, el verbo to be es am, is, are. ¿Sí? Am, is, and are. Es independiente. En el pasado, es was, and were.
Were.
Yes, and were. Entonces, was va a ser singular, digamos, I, he, she, it, was. Were, we, you, and they. Entonces, lo que sucede con el verbo to be es que él es independiente. Entonces, no necesita auxiliares. Usted no va a necesitar did para hacer una pregunta con el verbo to be. Usted no va a necesitar didn't para hacer una oración negativa con el verbo to be, porque el verbo to be es independiente. Entonces, si yo quiero decir, por ejemplo, yo estaba o yo estuve en el parque ayer, usted va a decir, I was in the park yesterday. Porque lo que usted quiere expresar cuando usted ocupa el verbo to be es nada más que usted estuvo en un lugar o que usted era de alguna manera en el pasado. Por ejemplo, puede decir, cuando yo era pequeño, yo era tímido. Entonces, ¿cómo va a decir? I was shy. Yo era tímido. Entonces, si se fijan, no hay otro verbo aparte del verbo to be. Solamente se ocupa un verbo. Entonces el verbo es was, que es el verbo to be. Si quiero hacer negativo, no puedo decir didn't, porque con el verbo to be no se necesita. Entonces solamente le voy a poner not. Yo voy a decir I was not, o ocupo la contracción. I wasn't shy. I wasn't in the park yesterday. ¿Sí? Y si es we, es were. Pero si es negativo, weren't. So you weren't in the park yesterday. They weren't in class yesterday. Si es una pregunta, tampoco es auxiliar, porque ya dijimos que el verbo to no necesita auxiliares. Entonces, simple, si la oración dice he was in the park yesterday, si la oración dice he was in the park yesterday, esa es una oración. Entonces, ¿qué voy a hacer? Nada más cambiar la posición del sujeto con el verbo to be. Sí, en vez de decir he was, yo voy a hacer la pregunta y voy a decir was he. Y ahí yo digo, was he in the park yesterday? Y aquí sí ya tiene la pregunta. Was he in the park yesterday? Esa es la pregunta. ¿Qué hizo? Nada más cambiar la posición del verbo to be. ¿Ocupó did? No, porque con el verbo to be no se ocupa auxiliar. So, was he in the park yesterday? Y aquí usted va a decir, yes, yes, he was. No, he wasn't. ¿Sí? Y aquí ya no ocupa didn't, no ocupa didn't, no ocupa did, porque solamente es el verbo. ¿Ves?
Okay. Okay, teacher. Thank you.
Teacher, I have other questions.
Yes.
Usted mencionó ahí de que no podemos utilizar los verbos.
Mm-hmm. Cuando es simple past.
¿Cómo podría expresar? Ajá. ¿Cómo ¿cuándo? Podría expresar, por ejemplo,
mm-hmm.
yo digo, yo estuve corriendo.
Era lo que le
decía. I was running.
Sí. Eso sí existe y es lo que les estaba explicando al inicio de la clase, pero eso no es simple past. Eso se llama past continuous. Eso se llama past continuous. Y el past continuous se ocupa cuando usted está contando una historia. Cuando usted quiere decir que algo estaba en proceso y algo más sucedió. Por ejemplo, usted dice, yo estaba corriendo cuando de repente un perro se atravesó. Entonces, eso es lo que usted está haciendo. Está contando algo que estaba sucediendo y que de repente se suspendió. Entonces, allí sí puede ocupar otro verbo a la par de was, pero lo pone con ing. Y eso ya no es simple past. Eso ya es past.
Okay.
Pero se ocupa para otro tipo de historia. No para decir que usted hizo algo. El simple past se utiliza para decir que usted hizo algo.
Ok.
Y el past continuous se ocupa para decir que usted estaba haciendo algo en un momento que otra cosa sucedió.
Ok. Alright. Thank you.
Entonces, no es lo mismo que yo le diga a usted, yo corrí 10 kilómetros ayer, a que yo le diga a usted, yo estaba corriendo 10 kilómetros ayer. Si yo le digo, yo estaba corriendo 10 kilómetros ayer, ajá, ¿y qué pasó? Me va a decir. ¿Y qué pasó? Porque va a esperar que yo le diga, yo estaba corriendo 10 kilómetros ayer, cuando de repente una ambulancia llegó y se atravesó porque había un accidente. Ya no pude seguir. Entonces, a eso se refiere cuando ocupa el past continuous. I was running. Eso sí existe, pero eso es contar una historia de algo que estaba pasando cuando de repente otra cosa sucedió. Entonces, es otra historia. Es para otro tipo de situaciones. El simple past se ocupa nada más para decir una cosa que inició y finalizó. Algo que nosotros hicimos. ¿Sí? ¿Qué hicimos? Inició. Ups. Inició y finalizó. ¿Yes? Another question? No? Okay, now let's see a little bit more about simple past.
What is the past simple of be? We can say, he is tall, about the present. What can we say about his past? He was short. This is called the past simple tense. We use the past simple to talk about the past. He was short is the positive. What is the negative? The negative is he wasn't short. Wasn't is the contraction of was not. Here are some more examples. I was a police officer. I wasn't a police officer. She was beautiful. She wasn't beautiful. It was expensive. It wasn't expensive. We were at home. We weren't at school. They were in Russia. They weren't in Thailand. So the past simple of be has two forms, was and were. Which one is singular and which one is plural? Was is singular and were is plural. But sometimes English doesn't always follow the rules. The pronoun you can be singular or plural, but we use were for both singular you and plural you. You were late to school. You weren't late to school. We can also make questions using the past simple. Why were you late to school? Were you late to school? The short answer for a yes-no question is, yes, I was. No, I wasn't. When were they in Russia? Were they in Russia? The short answers are, yes, they were. No, they weren't. How much was it? Was it expensive? And what are the short answers? Yes, it was. No, it wasn't. So remember, we use the past simple of be to talk about the past. The negatives are, was becomes wasn't, were becomes weren't. Was is singular, were is plural, and for you. The short answers to yes-no questions are, yes plus subject plus was or were. No plus subject plus wasn't or weren't. If you've enjoyed our video, please visit our website at umanzu.com to check out our latest videos. Subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button. And remember to like, comment, and share our
Okay, so that was the explanation about the verb in the past. Yes? Now, just to give you an example, I'm going to choose three people. I'm going to ask maybe a question with the verb be, maybe a question with another verb, and you have to answer. So let's start with Salvador Gomez. Salvador, did you drink coffee yesterday?
Yes, I drink coffee.
No, because drink is the present.
Yes, till drink.
No.
No.
Acuérdense. El verbo se ocupa en el presente nada más cuando ustedes hacen la pregunta o cuando ustedes lo hacen de forma negativa. ¿Por qué en la pregunta va en el presente? Porque tienen didn't en la pregunta. ¿Por qué en el negativo va en el presente? Porque tienen didn't. Pero en la oración positiva va a ir en el pasado. Solamente en el negativo y en la pregunta va en el presente. Entonces no puede decir drink. Yo le digo drink en la pregunta, sí, pero porque yo estoy ocupando did en la pregunta, por eso tengo que poner el verbo en el presente. Pero en la respuesta positiva usted no me puede decir drink. ¿Por qué no? Porque usted me está dando una respuesta positiva y allí no hay auxiliar.
Teacher, drink en pasado es drunk.
Drank.
Drank. Okay, yes, I drank coffee yesterday.
Exactly. Yes, I drank coffee yesterday. Si fuese negativo, how do you say it?
No, I drank.
Vuelvo y le digo.
No, sería, sí, sí, yeah. Mm-hmm. Sería, no, I didn't drink.
Ahí sí. Coffee. No, I didn't drink. Acuérdense que para pregunta, did. Para negativo, didn't. Y para positivo, el verbo en el pasado. So, did you drink coffee yesterday? Yes, I drank coffee yesterday. No, I didn't drink coffee yesterday. Good. Let's see another person. Roxana.
Teacher, teacher.
Yes?
Question. Mm-hmm. Ahí en el video vi una... Creo que era como oración, pero él usaba how much was y ahí salía un verbo. No me acuerdo muy bien qué era el verbo.
Lisa, how much was is it? How much was it?
How much? Vaya. Ahí no había ningún verbo. No había otro verbo, solo el verbo to be.
Solo el verbo to be estaba. Es que medio vi el...
Esta creo que era la pregunta, how much was it? Or not. I will play it again so that you can see it.
The último estaba. Deja hija.
This one. How much was it? Was it expensive? This one?
Yes, yo pensé que expensive lo usaba. How much was expensive?
No. Expensive.
Okay.
Expensive no es un verbo. Expensive es un adjetivo. Significa caro. Caro. Like, how much? ¿Cuánto? How much was it? ¿Cuánto era eso? ¿Cuánto valía? How much was
vaya, it? Y en ese caso, vaya, me confundí cabal en esa pregunta porque cuando dijo que cuando el verbo to be, el was pasaba al inicio. ¿Va?
Sí, pero cuando es pero una, este, cuando es una pregunta.
Sujeto.
No, cuando es una pregunta cerrada. Si ustedes se fijan, aquí tienen dos tipos de pregunta. La de arriba es una pregunta que se llama pregunta abierta o WH questions, que son preguntas que ustedes hacen con when, where, how, why, who. Esas son preguntas abiertas. Y esas no tienen la respuesta ni sí ni no, sino que si yo le pregunto a usted, ¿dónde vive? Where do you live? I live in San Salvador. Bye. Entonces ya me dio la respuesta. No dijo ni sí ni no. Ahora, si yo le digo que si usted trabaja, o si yo le pregunto si usted trabaja, do you work? Entonces ahí si usted me dice, yes, I work, or no, I don't work. Entonces ahí tiene sí o no. Esa fue una pregunta cerrada. La primera fue abierta. Lo mismo pasa aquí. Si es una pregunta abierta, primero le va a poner cómo, cuándo, dónde, por qué. ¿Sí? Y si es una pregunta cerrada, no lleva ese cómo, ni dónde, ni cuándo, ni por qué. Entonces, si se fija la de arriba, la primera, la mano izquierda dice, why were you late to school? ¿Por qué llegaste tarde o por qué estuviste tarde en la escuela? Y si no le quiere preguntar por qué, sino que solamente le quiere preguntar si estuvo tarde, entonces solamente dice, were you late to school? Y ahí se le va a responder, yes, I was, or no, I wasn't. Lo mismo, la segunda, when were they in Russia? ¿Cuándo estuvieron ellos en Rusia? Y la segunda, were they in Russia? ¿Estuvieron ellos en Rusia? Entonces, ¿qué significa? Que la de arriba es abierta y la de abajo es cerrada. ¿Qué tipo de pregunta puede hacer? Usted puede hacer una pregunta abierta y una cerrada. Lo que a usted le parezca, lo que usted quiera preguntar. Entonces, en este momento estamos viendo nada más preguntas cerradas. Por eso comenzamos nada más con el verbo to be. Pero si en un momento usted le quiere preguntar cómo, cuándo, dónde, por qué, entonces simplemente póngale cómo, cuándo, dónde y por qué al inicio. ¿Sí?
Ok, teacher. Yes.
Quítele, okay. Quítele why a la primera pregunta y ¿qué le queda? Cerrada.
Sí, cerrada. La
segunda, ¿qué le queda? Cerrada. Entonces, eso es la diferencia entre una pregunta abierta y cerrada, que usted está preguntando algo más específico. ¿Cómo, dónde, por qué, cuándo? ¿Sí? Y en la cerrada solamente quiere saber si sí o no. ¿Tienes hijos? ¿Tienes hijos? ¿Sí o no? Listo, es una pregunta cerrada. ¿Cuántos hijos tienes? Esa es una pregunta abierta. Porque ahí usted ya no me va a decir ni no, ni sí ni no, sino que una cantidad. Me estoy preguntando cuántas. O que yo le pregunte, ¿haces deporte? Usted me va a decir sí o no. Esa es una pregunta cerrada. Porque la respuesta es sí o no. Ahora, ¿qué tipo de deporte haces? Ahí ya no me va a decir ni sí ni no, sino que me va a dar una información específica. Lo que yo le estoy preguntando, ¿qué tipo? Ah, ok. Ya me responde que practica fútbol o básquetbol o natación, cualquier deporte. ¿Sí? Entonces esa es la diferencia entre abierto y cerrado. ¿Another question? No?
No, teacher.
Ok. Let's see another person, Roxana. Roxana. First question is not about the past, but do you live with your parents, Roxana?
Sorry.
Do you live with your parents?
Yes, I did.
No, listen, this is not the past. Do you live with your parents?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
I live in the car.
Perfect, perfect, Rosanna. Now I will ask you about the past. Was your mother in your house yesterday? Was your mother in your house yesterday?
Yes, he was a mother yesterday.
No, mother es su mamá, eso es lo primero que se pone, ¿verdad?
Yes. Mom was. Yes.
My mom was. Mi mamá estuvo o estaba.
Was. I don't remember the verb.
The question was your mother in your house yesterday? This is the question. Was your mother in your house yesterday?
Yes, mother was, and mother was yesterday.
The compliment.
Yes, no. Yes, my mother was house yesterday.
In my house yesterday. In my house yesterday. Si no me dicen in my house, me está diciendo nada más, mi mamá estuvo casa ayer. Dice, my mother was in my house yesterday. Good. Next person, Jorge Ramírez. Were you tall? Were you tall when you were a child? Were you tall when you were a child, when you were a kid? ¿Eras alto cuando eras un niño?
Yes, I was.
Good. Yes, I was. Or yes, I was tall. Yes, I was tall. Negative, no, I wasn't tall. No, no era alto. Entonces, si se fijan la diferencia entre la pregunta que le hice a Roxana, Jorge, y la que le hice a Salvador, son diferentes. A Roxana se la hice igual que a Jorge, preguntándole con el verbo to be. Was your mother in your house? Was your mother in your house? Yes, she was. Or yes, my mother was in my house. Jorge, were you tall? Yes, I was tall. Pero con Salvador fue diferente. Did, le dije did. ¿Por qué? Porque no ocupé el verbo to be. Estaba ocupando otro verbo. Entonces, con los miles de verbos que existen, ustedes siempre van a preguntar con did. Did you drink? Did you go? Did you swim? Did you play? Pero cuando ustedes quieren saber si una persona era, de cierta manera, o que si estaba en algún lugar, ocupen was or were, el verbo to be. Yes? So now let's see. Edwin González, ask Anthony any question using the verb be.
Okay. Anthony, were you working yesterday at night?
That is not a verb be. That is not simple past. Eso no es simple past. Eso es past continuous.
No, yeah. Were you in the house yesterday at night?
In your house? Mm-hmm.
Yes. I was in my house yesterday.
Good, thank you. Solamente recuérdense que cuando ocupan el verbo to be, lo único que quieren preguntar era, ¿eras algo o estuviste en un lugar? No estuviste haciendo algo. Si le pregunto, ¿estuviste haciendo algo? Eso ya es otro tiempo. En el simple past es, ¿eras algo? ¿Eras pequeño? ¿Eras alto? ¿Eras bonita? ¿Eras inteligente? ¿Eras tímido? ¿Cómo eras? ¿Yes? Y el otro es que si estabas en un lugar, estuviste en tu casa, estuviste en el parque, estuviste en clase, estuviste en el salón, estuviste en algún lugar, no haciendo algo. Haciendo algo es otra cosa, otra historia. ¿Yes? Now, Luis Quintanilla, ask Bimael with the verb be.
Okay. Bimael. Were you
intelligent in the school?
No. No, I were intelligent.
No, I wasn't.
Okay, no, I wasn't intelligent on the school.
Really, Abimael?
Yes, teacher.
Really?
Oh, I don't know. My score.
Eras inteligente en escuela.
And
you're saying no, I wasn't.
Yeah. Maybe yes. A little intelligent.
Okay. Yes, I was a little intelligent. Good. Good. Sí, porque si le dice que no era inteligente, le está diciendo algo negativo de usted, ¿verdad? Que usted era lo opuesto, inteligente. Entonces lo mejor es decir que sí, pero le recalca que un poquito y eso estuvo bien. Yes, I was a little intelligent. Para que no diga que era un gran genio, ¿verdad? Pero que algo se defendía. Yes, I was a little intelligent. Good. Tania, ask Josué using the verb.
Where again?
Josué.
Okay. Where the short in the chai?
Repeat it, Tania.
Where do short?
Short.
Yes, pequeño.
Mm-hmm. Short.
In the chai.
When you were a child, cuando eras un niño. When you were a child. Cuando tú eras un niño. When you were a child.
When you were a...
Esto no es pregunta, esto es parte de lo que usted preguntó al inicio, ¿no?
Ok. Entonces solo pregunto, when you... Were you short?
Were you short?
When you were a child?
Esa es la pregunta. Were you short when you were a child?
Okay.
Were you short when you were a child? Were you short?
When you short when you were a child?
Yes, Tania. I was short when I...
When I...
What?
I was short when I...
When I child.
When I was a child.
When I was a child. Lo dije así, pero tenía duda short. De que fuera así.
When I was a child. Cuando yo era un niño. When I was a child. Yes, I was short when I was a child. Edwin Alexander, ask Hector Lima using the verb be. About him, about his mother, his sister, his wife, his girlfriend, his co-workers, I don't know, whoever you want.
Oh, well. Was you work? Was you work overtime in yesterday?
¿Quién le quiere preguntar?
Que si estuvo trabajando horas extra.
Vale. Estuvo haciendo horas extra. Estuvo trabajando. Eso no es simple past.
Ah,
eso es past continuous.
Entonces, que si trabajó, que si trabajó, que si hizo.
Ah,
entonces, ajá.
Perfecto, vaya. Si usted le quiere preguntar que si trabajó, ahí no vamos a ocupar el verbo to.
Ah, did you work? Yes.
Ahí sí, did you work yesterday? Esa pregunta sí aplica, did you work yesterday? Pero yo quiero que le haga una pregunta con el verbo to be. Pregunta con el verbo to be. Eras, y ya le dice cómo, o estuviste en un lugar.
Was you in the work yesterday?
Were you at work yesterday?
Were you at work yesterday?
Ah, eso sí, ¿verdad? ¿Estuviste en el lugar de trabajo ayer? Were you at work yesterday?
Yes, I did.
Yes, I did. No.
Okay.
No le hice una pregunta con did él. No puede decir yes, I did.
Can you repeat, please? Again. Were you at work yesterday? Yes, I worked yesterday.
Mm-mm. ¿Qué le está preguntando él, Héctor?
No, teacher. I don't understand.
Es que lo que pasa es que ustedes todavía no tienen claro lo que significa el verbo to be. El verbo to be significa ser algo, ¿sí? O estar en un lugar. Eso es lo que significa el verbo to be, ser algo o estar en un lugar.
Okay.
Entonces, ¿qué es el verbo to be en el pasado? Se dice was o were, dependiendo del sujeto. Was para I, he, she, it, y were para we, you, they. ¿Qué le preguntó Edwin? Vaya, veamos qué le preguntó Edwin. Edwin le preguntó, were you at work? At work, le vamos a quitar work y le vamos a poner at Iron Man. Vaya, esto fue lo que le preguntó Edwin. Were you at Iron Man yesterday? Uy, se me fue la T. Héctor. ¿Estuviste en Iron Man ayer? Eso es lo que le está preguntando.
Okay.
Vaya, respóndale. Yes.
Yes, I was work yesterday.
No diga work, solamente yes, I okay. was.
Yes, y
el resto que él le está preguntando. I was at Iron Man yesterday. Yes, I was at. At es para el lugar. ¿Cuál es el lugar? Iron Man. Yes, I was at Iron Man yesterday. Yes. Entonces, no quiero que se confundan. El verbo to be es para describir cómo era usted antes o para decir dónde estaba usted, en qué lugar estaba. Para eso se ocupa el verbo to be. Entonces, es el único verbo con el que no se va a ocupar did. ¿Sí? En la pregunta no puede ocupar did con este verbo. Mucho menos en la respuesta, porque desde que la pregunta ya comienza con was o con were, su respuesta va a ser con was o con were también. Es como cuando le preguntan en el presente. En el presente, are you a doctor? Si yo le quiero preguntar, ¿eres tú un doctor? Are you a doctor? Su respuesta no va a ser yes, I do. ¿Por qué no? Porque no le estoy preguntando con do, entonces no me puede decir do en la respuesta. ¿Qué me tiene que decir? Yes, I am. Sí, yo soy. Yes, I am. ¿Sí? Entonces, ¿cómo sería are you a doctor en el pasado? Fácil. El verbo to be en el pasado para you, were. ¿Vale? Eso es todo. Were you a doctor? ¿Eras un doctor el año pasado? Were you a doctor last year? Yes, I was. No, I wasn't. Ahora sí quiero decir que Rubén está en el cine. Rubén is at the cinema. Bueno, Rubén is at the cinema. Rubén está en el cine. Y si yo quiero decir que Rubén estaba en el cine, fácil. Rubén was at the cinema. Y ahí estuvo. Rubén was at the cinema. Y ahí que estoy diciendo que Rubén estaba en el cine o estuvo en el cine. Listo. Entonces, el verbo to be, was and were solamente describe cómo eran ustedes o el lugar en el que estaban. Eso es todo. De allí, si usted quiere decir comer, jugar, saltar, trabajar, bailar, reír, fumar, cualquier cosa que se le ocurra, ocupe did. Did you go? Did you work? Did you play? Did you study? Did you swim? Yes? So, next question. Luis Enrique asked Sergio using the verb be.
The verb be?
Yes.
Okay. Sergio, were you in El Salvador the last year?
Perfect.
Okay. Yes, I was in El Salvador last year.
Perfect. Entonces, fíjense, lo está preguntando que si estaba en el país. Were you in El Salvador last year? Yes, I was in El Salvador. Good. Hugo, ask Jorge Ramírez. Using the verb be. Hugo?
Yeah.
Ask
Jorge. I don't know. Okay, were you in the beach on your last vacation?
At the beach.
Were you at the beach on your last vacation?
No, I wasn't.
Okay, that's great.
Good. No, I wasn't. Good. Now, Ruben, ask Edwin Gonzalez.
Okay, were you in the cafeteria at work yesterday at 8 o'clock?
Good.
No, I wasn't.
Good, thank you. Josué Vázquez, ask Héctor Lima. Jose Vázquez, ask Héctor Lima. Jose.
Que le pregunte, me dijo, ¿verdad?
Yes, ask Héctor Lima.
Héctor.
Tell me.
Pero vean, no se me ocurre que preguntarte.
With the verb be.
What?
Using the verb be.
Ah, the verb be. Héctor was on the work Wasn't the world at midnight yesterday?
Who? ¿Quién?
¿Cómo?
¿Quién? ¿Sobre quién está preguntando?
A él estaba preguntando si él estuvo en la...
Vaya, porque si de lo que usted dijo, was... ¿Qué dijo? Was...
Was... Ah, sorry, sorry. Was you in the world...
Was you...
Was you in the world...
Was se ocupa nada más para I, para he, para she y para it.
Were.
Were se ocupa para we, para you y para they.
Ah, sorry, sorry. Were you in the world yesterday at midnight?
That's different.
No, I wasn't.
Good. No, I wasn't. So, we are going to stop here. Nos vamos a detener por acá. Vaya, necesito que practiquen un poquito más porque estos temas del pasado lo vieron en el nivel anterior, ¿verdad? Ya vieron el pasado en el nivel anterior, en el básico 13, mira. Entonces, este es como el último nivel donde ustedes van a ver un poco el pasado. Entonces, la idea en el principiante 4 no es de que yo les esté ya explicando cómo se hace, sino que la idea es de practicarlo. Pero he visto que a ustedes todavía les cuesta un poco, por eso les he estado explicando paso a paso para que puedan comprenderlo. Pero sí necesito que en su casa se pongan a practicar un poquito más. Así vamos avanzando con mayor facilidad. Y para el lunes sí necesito que ya vengan como más frescos, que practiquen el sábado y el domingo. Ahora, a partir de este día por la tarde, ustedes van a encontrar en Schoology la carpeta de la semana 3. Yo les voy a decir cuáles actividades van a completar, ¿sí? Porque normalmente les pido las actividades para el fin de semana para que no se vayan atrasando. Pero me interesa más que aprendan, que practiquen el pasado, entonces les voy a dejar actividades del pasado para este fin de semana, si ustedes practican, y ya el lunes venimos más claros, ¿sí? No quiero que mezclen las cosas, entonces por eso les decía, el simple past es para algo que terminó, no está usted escribiendo algo que estaba pasando, ¿sí? Listo. Y el verbo to be se ocupa nada más para decir que usted era de una manera o que usted estaba en un lugar, no que estaba haciendo algo, sino que estaba en un lugar. Listo. De allí, si usted quiere ocupar cualquier verbo, work, play, read, study, ocupe did. Did you work? Did you play? Did you study? Did you swim? Did you dance? Listo. Entonces, practiquemos un poquito este fin de semana sobre el pasado y así el lunes que ustedes ya vengan, van a poder entender todas las actividades que tienen que completar. Porque si se las dejo ahorita, no las van a poder lograr porque todavía ya más o menos entendieron, ya las últimas preguntas ya las iban creando, pero aún tienen cierto vacío allí que todavía les falta. Entonces sugiero que este fin de semana trabajemos en actividades que sean relacionadas solamente al simple past, así ya el lunes vienen claro, les explico las actividades que tienen que cumplir y las van a desarrollar de una manera más fácil. ¿Yes? So, Héctor Alvarado. Héctor Alvarado. Héctor. Héctor Alvarado is not here. Well, Herbert, yes, but he had a problem with energy. Sergio.
Present.
Almael.
Present.
Dania.
Present.
Rubén.
Present.
Salvador.
Present.
Edwin.
Present.
Tomás, he's not here, he has for permission. Héctor,
present.
Nelson Hugo, Hugo, well,
I am here, teacher.
Jose, he's not here. Luis Quintanilla,
present, teacher.
Jorge,
present.
Anthony,
I am here, teacher.
Edwin Sosa.
Present.
Roxana.
Present, teacher.
Well,
present, teacher.
Okay, so we are going to stop here and we will continue on Monday. I will send you activities to the WhatsApp group. Yes? So I see you on Monday and have a nice weekend. Practice at home. Yes? Bye, guys.
Thanks.
Okay. Bye.